Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 4.9 in the module 4, Patent CPM. The topic is Crashing the Patent Network. In the earlier lecture also, we discussed the problem on crashing the patent network. We will continue with another example in the crashing of the patent network. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to find the critical path of a network, patent network, by crashing the activities. We take example number 13. Consider the CPM network with the details given. Draw the network, find the earliest time, latest finish time, slack for each event. Also find the optimum duration and the minimum project cost. The activities, there are 6 activities, 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 3, 2, 4, 3, 4, 4, 5. The normal times are 20, 25, 10, 12, 5 and 10. The crash time are 17, 25. So, the activity 1, 3 cannot be crashed. 25, 8, 6, 2 and 5. The normal cost are 600, 200, 300, 400, 300 and 300. And crash cost will be 720. 200, 450, 700, 420 and 600. The activity 1-3 cannot be crashed based on the conditions. And here in this example, the indirect cost is not given. So, we take indirect cost equal to 0. We consider only the direct cost to calculate the total cost of the project work. So, the earliest start time, latest completion time and the slack of all the events are shown in the network here. So, 1-2, 1-3, 2-3, 3-4, 2-4 and 4-5. The TE values are shown at the bottom left and the TL value, latest time, was given in the bottom right, and the slack value for all the event, slack equal to 0, and the critical path of this network is 1-2, 2-3, 3-4 and 4-5. So, the critical path is 1-2, 2-3, 3-4 and 4-5. The direct cost is the sum of the normal cost of all activities when they executed in the normal time. The normal time is 45 days for the network. So, total cost equal to direct cost plus indirect cost. So, direct cost is 21,000. Indirect cost equal to 0. So, the total cost is 21,000. Now, we calculate the cost slope of the various activities. They are given in the table below. So, activity 1, 2, the normal time 20, normal cost 600. Crash time 17, normal crash cost equal to 720, delta T is NT minus ET, 17 minus 20 minus 17 equal to 3, and 720 minus 600 equal to 120, cost slope equal to 40, delta C by delta T equal to 40. For activity 1-3, there is no change, so delta T, delta C and the cost slope, they are 0. For 2-3, the delta T value 10 minus 8 equal to 2, delta C value 450 minus 300 equal to 150, so, 150 divided by 2 equal to 75. For activity 2-4, delta T equal to 12 minus 6 equal to 6, delta C equal to 700 minus 400 equal to 300, and 300 divided by 6 equal to 50. For activity 3-4, delta T 5 minus 2 equal to 3, and delta C 420 minus 300 equal to 120, so the cost slope is 40. Activity 4-5, delta T equal to 10 minus 5 equal to 5 and delta C equal to 600 minus 300 equal to 300 and the cost slope equal to 300 divided by 5 equal to 60. Now, crashing the activity 1, 2. So, the cost slope, the lowest cost slope is 40. 1, 2 and 2, 3, 4, they have lowest cost slope. Then we have 2, 4 is 50, 2, 3, 7, 2, 4, 5, 60 and 2, 3, 75. We take one by one. First, the activity 1-2 is crashed. The cost slope is 40. Crashed from 20 days to 17 days. So, the 20 days, it is reduced to 17 days. Now, the project duration, instead of 45 days, now it is reduced to 42 days. We calculate all the value. Now, the critical path is continuous. 1-2, 2-3, 3-4 and 4-5. There is no change in the critical path. The time is reduced. Time required is reduced to 42 days. And the direct cost equal to total direct cost of the previous network plus time saved by crashing the activity into cost slope of the crashed activity. So, previous network direct cost is 21,000. Now here time saved equal to 20 minus 17 equal to 3 into 40 equal to rupees 21,120. There is no indirect cost. So total cost equal to rupees 21,120. Next we crash the activity 3-4. Again the cost slope is 40. Crashed from 5 days to 2 days. So it is reduced now. So now 3-4 activity 3-4 it is here 5 days. It is reduced to 2 days. Now the project duration is reduced to 39 days. So all the other calculation, TE value, TL value, identify the critical path, everything is very much, you are very much familiar from the previous video lectures. Now the time record is reduced to 39 days. Instead of 42 days, now it is reduced to 39 days. Now the direct cost equal to total direct cost of the previous network plus time saved by crashing the activity into cost slope of the crashed activity. So 21,120 plus 3 into 40. So the activity 5 days is reduced to 2 days. So 3 days is saved. 3 into 40 equal to rupees 21,240. So the total cost equal to 21,240. So there is no indirect cost. Indirect cost equal to 0. Then the crashing the activity 2-4 with the cost slope 50. So 2-4 is 12 days. It is reduced to 6 days now. So it is reduced to 6 days. Now there is no change in the project duration, 39 days. So there is no change. And total direct cost, so direct cost equal to total direct cost of the previous network plus time saved by crashing the activity into cost slope of the crashed activity. 21,240 plus 6 into, so 6 days are saved, 6 into 50 equal to 21,540, so the total cost equal to 21,540. Then crashing the activity 4-5 with the cost slope of 60 and the time is crashed to 10 days to 5 days. So 4-5, so 10 days is the normal time and it is crashed to 5 days. Now the duration is reduced from 39 days to 34 days. So time record is reduced to 34 days and the direct cost equal to total direct cost of the previous network plus time saved by crashing the activity into cost slope of the crashed activity. So 21,540 is the cost of the previous network. In here 5 days are saved, 5 into 60 equal to 21,840 and the total cost equal to 21,840 because there is no the indirect cost equal to 0. Now the crashing the activity 2-3 with the cost slope of 75 crashed from 10 days to 8 days. So 10 days 2-3, 10 days is reduced to 8 days. Now the time is reduced to 32 days. Now the direct cost we calculate, total direct cost of the previous network plus time saved by crashing the activity into cost slope of the crashed activity, 21,840 plus 2 into 75 equal to rupees 21,990. So indirect cost equal to 0. So total cost equal to 21,990. Then further crashing is not possible. All the activities in the critical path they are crashed. So the table, the consolidated table of the result. So initially it is total duration, normal time is 45 days. Total cost equal to 21,000. So crashing 1-2 reduced to 42 days, 21,120. Crashing 3-4. Reduced to 39 days, 21,240. Crashing the active 2-4, the 39 days, there is no change in the time, but the cost increases to 21,540. Reducing, crashing the 4-5, it is reduced to 34 days, 21,840. So, crashing the activity 2-3, it is reduced to 32 days, so the cost will become 21,990. So, further crashing is not possible. All the activities in the critical path, they were crashed. So further crashing is not possible. So we stop here. The answer to the problem, the project duration, total duration is 32 days and the total cost is 21,990. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. So there is one book, Operation Research. You can refer to it for additional information on the PET CPM network. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my WhatsApp number or mail ID for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again with another video lecture in the PET CPM. Until then, bye.